Hi. In this video, we'll be looking at some new features for paths in Substance Painter 11. Let's take a look at this wing on the dragon at the back, and we'll be using the filled path to create some shapes similar to this. So to use that, first of all, you have to create a new empty layer, and then you select the path tool. Now, by default, you'll have the paint along path selected, but if you click the tool again, you'll see a list of tool options, and you can choose the filled path over there. Filled path works similar to the regular paint along path. So you click to create a shape and it automatically adds tangents. And you'll see once I click on the last one to close it, you get a filled shape that shows up on your mesh. Now, this is just a quick test, but one thing I want to point out is that these green stripes that you're seeing here, they're actually options for the normals and they show how deep this shape is projected. So if I change that, which is also new, you look at the path options at the top here, you see the type, the depth. If I change the depth, you should see the length of the normals change. You can even type in values here, because if I look closely on the other side, they're projected through. So if I were to type in a tiny value of, say, 0.05, I still get some projection to the other side, and I can reduce this a little bit. So for example, 0.03, or I might want to go even smaller, 0.01. And you can see in this case, it's a little bit too small. So you want to find an in-between, obviously, that works for your case. Now, let me get rid of that one, remove it. And when you're drawing paths, something that's new as well is if you click and shift click, you create straight lines. So this is similar when using the regular brush tool, and I'm going to create a little jagged shape similar to the existing ones that are already on there, and then close my shape like that. So I've got a single one now, and keep in mind that these filled paths, they only fill with solid values. So you cannot actually paint materials with them. You can paint materials if you use them as a mask. So you could just create a new mask and in a paint layer, use them there. In this case, they're just filling with solid colors. So I'm going to really quickly go for a color that's similar-ish to what we already have, like that. And say I would want to add a stroke around this now. How would I create two different variations of that? Well, you can select the path, control D to duplicate it, and I have two separate ones now. They're both exactly the same, but I can convert the type. You do it two ways. You can right-click it and change the type to be paint along path. Then you see it gets painted, and it's very thick now, right now, because the size is too big. So I'll reduce the size a lot, like that. And again, just as before, I can change these settings so that it looks like another fill running around it. Another way to do this, and you could actually use this to go between multiple layers, say that I don't want these two to be on the same layer. So I'm actually going to remove this path. I'm going to copy it. Then I'll create a new layer. I'll start a quick new path here, not do much to it, and then say paste. But instead of paste, I'll say paste all vertices. And this actually pastes the vertices, the actual shapes from the last path into the new one. So that's another way to sync paths. And then again, you can obviously change the type to be paint along path and then do the same thing here. So this would have to be tweaked a little bit. Tricks you can do on this, of course, are adding a filter. For example, I would add a filter here. And I could choose a warp. And let's wait for that to calculate. So that tweaked, another thing that you can do is right up here, if this path gets in the way, you can show or hide the viewport interface. In some cases, they might actually get in your way, so you can just toggle it on and off to see what's going on. This is not a new feature, but people might have missed it so far. Another thing that you can do while you're drawing paths that's also new, so if we start a new one, is you can turn on snapping. So snapping snaps to the mesh wireframe, and you see that the mesh wireframe turns on, and there's actually settings for it. I can say snap to mesh wireframe to vertices, to edges, or to edge centers. With snapping activated, when you draw a path, it will snap to the closest vertex position. You can change this, as mentioned before, up here. The hotkey for snapping is Shift Z, and you hold Z for temporary snapping. Another thing you can do is you can use angle snapping now. So if you hold Control Shift, then you should see that your path lines are snapping to increments of 45 degrees. This can be modified as well. If you open up the settings, you'll see here, there's an angle step setting. You can set it to every 1, 5, 15, 30, 45, and 90 degrees. You can also set the reference. So in screen space means it's always aligned to the camera. A vertex space means it's aligned with your mesh, and world space means it's aligned with the world. Use whatever you feel fits. So once again, it's control shift to do specific angle snaps. And you can do very precise shapes with that. Lastly, paths can also be transformed. So when you turn on the transform manipulator, you can actually move paths in a different way. Normally the way to move points is to drag on them, but if you turn on the transform manipulator, you can actually move them with a 3D gizmo. You can select multiple points as well. If you use shift to click them, it lets you move multiple points at the same time. Keep in mind that this isn't always the easiest to use, since it will align to the world when you're doing this, but it lets you move an entire path over fairly quickly without having to drag each point individually. That's a quick overview of most of the new features that are in the new path tools for Substance Painter 11. I hope you have fun with them.